We're here in the back room of Connecticut Art Fair. It's just a really interesting art fair because it represents the artists who are using the latest in technology to create their works. And it's an interesting platform for exploration, because the exploration that we're going to do over the course of the coming weeks and months is try and build an understanding of what makes the art market. Some kind of way of assessing what is the value of an art piece. What defines what makes one artist collectible and another artist not collectible? I'm trying to invent an algorithm. This is the whole purpose of this, is to try and work out what is the art algorithm. I mean, everything else, this massive amount of art data out on the internet. What makes someone come through? Is it them being a great artist?
It's not necessarily that. Yeah. That might help, but ultimately it is having that demand. So people knowing about that work, more than one person wanting it, more than one person with a lot of money wanting it and pushing the price up.
So it's about exposure.
Yeah. Ultimately, building a buzz around something so that people start talking about it increases its people's awareness of it. It increases the value of the artwork. Yeah. We did an auction ourselves. We've done two auctions. We did one at the art fair last year, and we did one.
The system crashed, didn't it?
Which we tried that. I mean, obviously you've got your auctioneers, Christie's and so on, who that's what they do. So that's the best way of doing it. Yes.
So we're here in East London right now. East London is the centre of the fringe art scene. So you just walk around the streets here, and it's this beautiful old London, and it's become a critical part of London's art scene, that there's that people create the most amazing sculptures and street art and paint on wall, and it's really been embraced. And it just feels like a really appropriate place to start this exploration, this attempt to try and understand what is this $66 billion art market. These are statistics from Bloomberg in 2014. What is the $66 billion art market? Who is engaging in it? And more importantly, how does it work? How do the metrics work? And I just think it's this mysterious world that, you know, today we're going to scratch the surface, but start trying to uncover what are the key drivers behind this market, what makes a great art piece. And so I can't help feeling that a critical part of the art market today, and one that certainly, as far as I can tell, hasn't been tapped, is starting to track the traffic to artists' websites, the number of tweets that artists get, the number of mentions that they get in the social sphere, the number of shares, tracking the movement of those likes and shares, and starting to get a sense of which artists are having an impact on society, because that feels to me like a direct measure. And so if I'm going to take a punt at a predictive variable in this algorithm, I would say traffic, internet traffic. It's like those Buddhist, what are those Buddhist mandalas that they create out of sand? And these monks in the Himalayas create these beautiful artworks out of sand. Months, years, lifetimes, I don't know. And then when they finish, they open the doors of the temple and all the sand blows away. It's beautiful.
Well, maybe they're the true artists then. Maybe that's, they've spotted the flaw.
Not great from a pricing strategy. No, if we're talking about the art market,
definitely not good.
Yes, well, but I can explain it. Basically, I started with £1, and I went to a charity shop and I bought something for £1, and I decorated it, and then I went to a pub and sold it for £2, and then I'm repeating that same idea. When I sell one level, it funds the next level. So I'm not actually making any money. It's just I've called it an exponential self-funding, and it's a framework for me to create all of my ideas in 20 steps, and each time it's doubling in money and funding. So and it seems to be working very well. I've just got halfway. I'm on level 10 at the moment, and I'm selling level 11 here at the Connecticut Arts Fair.
Great.
Yeah. Yes, exactly. Yeah. I mean, I'm kind of I made up the rules, so I can change them slightly if I want to, you know.
It's kind of can be very temporary. Technology is very temporary. I mean, the idea of writing, creating an artwork which is going to last for 10 years or 50 years or 100 years is not a problem that most programmers have to face. You know, I used to write code for 5 years. That was my aim. And now I'm trying to write code for 100 years. So if I create a piece of work for sale, you know, there are some people obviously who buy it for investment. There are some people who will buy it because they like it. But you don't want that to go away. You know, you don't want it to stop working. So as a digital artist, I'm, you know, really actively working to establish my own sort of ground rules that I can then share with other people to add value to digital art, you know, so it becomes a viable platform.
I'm just looking through the notes. I've been scribbling down notes as we've been going today. And I think the essence that I'm drawing out, if we start thinking about the algorithm and looking how we could design it, some of the factors in the algorithm could be publicity, craft, space. So what I'm feeling like the early stages of this algorithm is that the number of exhibitions and the scale of the exhibitions that an artist has engaged with and been in is definitely a predictor. My first port of call would be to buy art auction data, would be to scrape gallery sites and see which artists are represented by galleries, to then monitor because gallery spaces are important, to then monitor the tweets and Facebook postings and Tumblr shares around those artists. Just those few factors, I think, would start to make an already more predictive algorithm than walking into the doors of a gallery and saying, how great is this artist? And the gallerist saying, this artist is amazing. Like, just tracking those variables would already completely change your understanding of who that artist is. So that's the starting point for today.